In the Father and the Son
and the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. Today's gospel from the book of Matthew chapter 12 start with a story about a man that the Bible mentioned. He was demon-possessed, blind, and mute. And the Lord came, demon-possessed, blind, and mute. Many of the fathers consider this is a symbol of a sinner. When someone far away from God, he's controlled by demons. Also, someone far away from God, he's blind, he cannot see. And that's why we see beautiful, many, many miracles in the Bible about opening the eyes. And Jesus can open our eyes to see things different. And also, a man, he's mute, he cannot listen, he cannot understand. And the Bible mentioned that the Lord healed him so that the blind and the mute both spoke and also saw. He starts speaking and see. Then following that, two types of people actually react to this miracle here. And normally in life, you always find two types of people. The Bible mentioned actually the first type, the multitude were amazed and said, could this be the son of David? The multitude start to react what Jesus did and said, wow, this is a beautiful miracle. Could be the son of David, which means could be this one the Messiah. He is the promised. He's the one who will come and save us. That's the multitude. But sadly enough, the Pharisees respond differently. They start actually judging Jesus himself. And they said, you know what, this fellow does not cast out demons except by Baal Zebul, which is the head of demons. So actually they called Jesus, he's the head of demons. And I always say in life, always, even in the church, at work, at school, with your friends, you always find two types of people. Something happened, people start praising God, say something positive. Something happens, start people criticizing, and they start to actually criticize Jesus. They look at Jesus and said, you know what? You cast out demons because you're actually the head of demons. And Jesus responded to them and said to them, you know what? Every kingdom divided against itself is brought into dissolution, and every city and every house divided against itself will not stand. He said, if I'm the head of demons, I'm cast out demons, that means I'm actually working against myself. And he started to actually give them analogy about really every kingdom and every house shall not divide amongst himself. Later, also he spoke to them about blasphemy against the Holy Spirit. He said, every sin will be forgiven except the blasphemy against the Holy Spirit. Which you believe that, as Bob Shenouda actually taught us, blasphemy against the Holy Spirit, a sin that cannot be repented. So every sin can be forgiven. But when you commit a sin and the Holy Spirit touching you, telling you, go confess, and you reject the Holy Spirit, that's basically blasphemy against the Holy Spirit. Then in the end of the gospel, which I want to focus on today, Jesus said, by your words, you will be justified, and by your words, you will be condemned. بكلامك تبرر وبكلامك إيه تدان. By your words, you will be justified, and by your words, you will be condemned. And we honestly could sit for a few minutes, think about this beautiful verse here. Whatever you say, actually, it will judge you on that judgment day. If it's good, you will be actually will judge, and you will go to the resurrection of life. If it's bad, you will go to the resurrection of condemnation. So therefore, it's very important. The one thing I want to speak to you about today, your words or your tongue. Your words and your tongue. Especially, I'm sure all of us will struggle with really sometimes when we run to any situation, we struggle with harsh words. We cannot many times in many situations in life, I always said, I wish I control my tongue. I wish I did not say that. Many words we say. For Jesus actually telling us, our Lord God, Jesus Christ telling us, by your words, you will be justified on the judgment day. And by your words also, you will be condemned. And it tells us, you know what? Your tongue can get you into heaven, or your tongue can get you somewhere else. And he said, for out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speak. What that means? Out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speak. Which means actually, the tongue or your words reveals what's in your heart. The tongue and your words reveal what's in your heart. If it's your heart pure, everything come out of your mouth pure. If your heart is evil, everything out of your mouth is evil. That's why he said to them, a good man out of the good treasure of his heart bring forth good things, and an evil man out of the evil things, a treasure of his heart will bring forth evil things. For therefore, make sure your heart is clean. I love this beautiful analogy because it's not just only about what you say. What you say actually reveal what's in your heart. What you say reveal what's inside you. If your heart is pure and clean, everything will come out of your mouth very beautiful and clean. But if your heart full of judgment and full, you like to judge people, you will find your heart also full of evil. Therefore, he said to them, but I say to you that every idle word man may speak, they will give account of it in the day of the judgment, which means it's a tough message for us. Every idle word that you will say, it will be actually stood against us, or it will support us on the judgment day. For therefore, today the message, very simple, by your words you will be justified, and by your words you will be condemned. Make sure, as we always, the beautiful little song when we're baby, be only, oh, be careful, little eye, what you see. Also, oh, be careful, little tongue, what you say. Oh, be careful, little tongue, what you say. Because what you say, it will actually reflect who you are. What you say, reflect who you are. So today, I just want to go with a few verses. I'm not just reading some verses from the Bible and comment on it for a little bit about the importance and the power of the tongue, or the importance of the power of what we say or our words. First reading I will read for you from Ephesians chapter 4, verse 29. He said, let no corrupt word proceed out of your mouth. Let no corrupt word. So this is a message by the Bible telling us, be careful, even little corrupt word. Sadly enough, right now, so many foul language we always use, and everybody's saying this. And I remember one of the youth came to me for confession. He told me about a few words he said, Abuna, I cannot control myself. Because everybody say it. Every movie I watch, that's what we use. Everything, and it comes out of your mouth. And even, I have no control over it. I told him, you know, start to watch something good. And also start actually to read the Bible and recite the word of God. Let the word of God proceed out of your mouth. For therefore, everything will become unclean. Let no corrupt word proceed out of their mouths. St. Peter, actually, in 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 10, said something very beautiful. He said, for whoever would love life, I'm sure all of us will love life. We love to have a good life and live a good life. For whoever loved life and wanted to see good days must keep their tongue or their words from evil and their lips from deceitful words. Make sure if you love life and you want to live a good life, you want to be happy, everybody will be happy with you. You know what? Make sure what your tongue will control you, what you say. I remember actually some lady was in, I know her very well, in the hospital. But even during her sickness and struggle and all the pain that she suffered with, when she talked to the nurse and everybody around there, she spoke to them very kindly, very nicely. To the point the nurse considered her like a saint. This woman is beautiful. You know, even if she's in pain, she always asks them in a very nice way, in a polite way. For everything come out of her mouth, very polite. I was amazed one time when I went visit her in the hospital. Everybody in the station, when I asked about her, she said, it's such a blessing woman, such a great woman, such a woman that we'll love to be close to her. But make sure, you know what, if you want to live a happy life and you want to see good days, what will help you is your tongue and what you say. Another verse from Proverbs chapter 15, verse 1 and 2, which a verse I'm sure all of you know very well. Soft or gentle answer take away wrath. Soft or gentle answer take away from us. Once you say a soft answer or a gentle answer will take away wrath. Soft and gentle answer will take away wrath, but a harsh word stirs up anger. So a harsh word will stir up anger. Said ya habibi. So make sure that, you know what, a soft answer will be very important. How many times you and I in many situations we say, I wish I say a soft answer. Especially in the family with your friend. I hope today to tell yourself, you know, God, teach me how to have a soft answer. Teach me, Lord, how when I run into a problem, how to have a gentle answer. Actually, the, Solomon also said in Proverbs chapter 18, verse 1, he said, death in life. Death and life are the power of the tongue. Death and life are the power of the tongue. This is a very beautiful verse, by the way. Yani, which means death, your, the power of your tongue can send somebody to death, or somebody can eat to life. And I tell you, I was reading an article and they said so many people die from the power from tongues more than who die by the gun or by any kind any other things. Because he can say something to hurt somebody emotionally, and that will struggle with them throughout their life. But if he kills somebody, he will go to heaven or go to hell. But he killed the person. But sometimes our word can kill people. So our word can affect people. Death and life are the power of the tongue. Even when you go to the court, you find the witnesses and their power and what they say. So I hope today you can tell yourself, teach me, Lord, how to control my tongue. Teach me, Lord, how to be soft in my answer. If you struggle with this, I tell you a good story actually by one of the father. One time, one of the men is struggling so much, was basically, he's very harsh when he speak. He gets angry quickly. He cannot control his tongue. He went so many times to his spiritual father. For one time, his spiritual father told him, you know, I want you to go get some leaves from the tree. So the man went to get some leaves. He said to him, you know, I want you to go to every house in the town and take one leaf and put it in the front of the house. So he took the leaves and went around the town, put one leaf in the front of every house. A few days, he came to, I went, I put all the leaves around the house. He said, go gather all the leaves again. Taban, for sure, when he get there, all the wind, take the leaves away, he did not find them. He said, be careful, because whatever you say will never come back to you. You cannot gather again. Whatever you say, it will actually stick with you. Sometimes we can say something very hard. How many times you and I would say something and we regret? We regret, we keep regretting. How many times we say something and say, I did not say that. I did not say that. Truly, he did not say that because he did not mean it. But be careful for what you say. I will give you a beautiful prayer, just I hope during today's liturgy. If you have a struggle with your tongue, if you have a struggle with your words, if you really struggle with the harsh words, and you know that that can be a judging during on the judgment day, David the prophet and the king give a beautiful, beautiful prayers. You will find in Psalm 141, verse 3, he said, set a guard over my mouth. Let's say it together. Set a guard over my mouth, Lord. Keep watch over the door of my lips. Which means, O Lord, come, set a guard over my mouth, and also keep watch every word that comes out of your mouth. I want to have a filter and make sure you put a filter in my mouth so every word that comes out with a filter to be nice and good. I will say the prayer again by David in Psalm 141, verse 3. Set a guard over my mouth, Lord. Keep watch over the door of my lips. اللي هي ضحافظا لفمي وبابا حسينا لإيه لشفتي. يقول له رب أو God, help me to control my tongue, to control my words, so that on the judgment day I will stand before to you. I say, out of the good treasure of my heart, I said everything good. May God bless you. May God help you. And may God help all those who struggle with, really, with a bad tongue or bad words. And hopefully all of us, and my message to the little children, make sure, be careful with the little word that you say. Even whatever language, make sure that what comes out of your mouth, not a corrupt word, proceed out of your mouth, but always to be a good word, a word that glorifies God. May God bless you, and glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.